Okay, my name is Zara, the TA of this course, and this is my email address for follow-up questions. We are going to, for today, briefly review vector loops and vector formations, and then we solve a related example together. Okay. Okay, we use vector loops to analyze velocity and acceleration of the mechanisms using equations. We represent the position of any points in Cartesian coordinates by a positioning vector called R, which has length r and direction theta, which is defined counterclockwise up from right. And it has two components, a vertical component and a horizontal component. This one is x and this one is y. X would be r cosine theta and y would be r sine theta, and we write the positioning vector r like this. There are other representation and notation for this. Okay, and these are other notations used for representing the positioning vector. In order to analyze velocities and accelerations of the mechanism, first we represent the mechanism by using some simple links and positioning vectors. Mechanism like this, 4 bar, link. You have seen it in the class. We represent the links by positioning vectors, R2, R3, and R4. We also have another link, R1, which is the ground. Ground is also a link, and we form a loop. Okay, and then we write loop equation for that. We start anywhere in the mechanism like this, and we go from head to tails, R2 plus R3 plus R4 and R1, and we end where we restored and put sum to zero. Okay, these are the thetas, which is, this one is theta 2, theta 3, which is counterclockwise, and for link 4 we have this, theta 4. And for link 1 we have this. Okay, we can also assume a reverse direction for R4 and also for R1 and use this theta instead of theta 4. And also for R1, theta 1 is something like this, 180, but we can reverse the direction and use okay, and theta 1 prime equals 0. Okay. This is a vector loop equation, which is actually two equations because it has two components, vertical component and horizontal component. And sometimes we can have more than one loop, but for each loop we can solve for maximum two unknowns because we only have two equations, vertical equation and horizontal equation. Each loop we include the key parameters of the mechanism that define the state of the mechanism, like all R's and thetas. R3 cosine theta 3. Because we reverse the direction of R4 and R1, we have to put minus here. We have two equations for each loop and we can solve for maximum two unknowns. Okay, the key parameters that define the state of the mechanisms are all R's and all theta. Some of them are constants, some of them are variables and changing with time. Some of them are known and some of them are unknown that must be calculated. And then we solve these equations for the unknowns or dependent variables. Okay, and then we take the derivatives of the solved dependent variables and calculate velocities or speeds and accelerations. We have two options for taking the derivatives. We can take the derivatives of the solved dependent variables, or if it's not straightforward, we can take the derivative of these two basic equations and then solve for velocities and accelerations. We have two options, option A and option B. Okay, this was a brief review for vector loop and loop formation, and we can solve an example together. Counterclockwise or not sure. I think it's counterclockwise. Okay, for this mechanism we want to find the velocity of point D and the input variable is theta 2 and we want to calculate the velocity for point D. This would be R2. The ground R1 and R4. Okay. Constants are theta 1, which is 180. input variables are okay, for the loop closure, we start from here, this point, we would have R2 plus R3 minus R4 minus R1 equals to 0. Okay, in the above equation, we have R2, R3, theta 2, and R1, and we can calculate for theta 3.
Calculate it. This is strange.
We find the problem. We can find theta 3 from here and then substitute it to the second equation and find R4. Sorry? Yes, I mean that the vertical direction, the vertical component. Yeah. Yes, maybe the name was not actually correct. I should write horizontal component and vertical component. Thank you. R2, theta 2, R3, we calculated theta 3, so we can have R4. Okay, for velocity of point B, which is R.4, we take derivative of this equation, which would be R2 is a constant, is not changing with time, but theta 2 is changing, theta 2 dot, cosine theta 2. Can you see this? No? R3 is also a constant, but theta 3 is changing with time. Okay, in order to calculate this velocity, we have to first calculate the derivative of theta 3. For that, we use the B option and take the derivative of the basic equations to calculate theta dot 3. And R1 is constant, so it has not any derivative, so it must be equal to 0. Would be R2 theta dot 2. Have this, so we can calculate theta dot 3, which is clockwise. We can substitute theta dot 3 to this equation and calculate r dot 4, which is the velocity of point D. I don't have it. No. Okay, I didn't calculate it actually, but it doesn't matter. Is there any equation from this example and the solution? No? Everything was clear? Thank you. Yes. Yeah. Yes, they can cross, and then you have to go wherever you start and end it there. Yeah. Okay. We added another link here, and now we want to calculate the velocity of point C this time. Okay. The constants RO2 is... okay, we have RBC. In order to calculate the velocity of point C, we need another loop, which would be something like this. Again, R2. R5. R6.
7 and theta 8. Okay, independent variables or inputs would be R4, and which we calculated in the previous loop.
Okay, here theta 5 is equal to theta 3. And we calculated using the first loop. And theta 6 is theta 3 plus 90. So R7 would be okay, then we take the derivative of R7.
derivative of this.
Okay, and the velocity of point C would be R dot 7 I plus R dot A J. It would be something like this. Okay, is there any question for this example? We use this loop, something like this, and we have other options. For the loop, we can use something like this. This would be another loop. It should be. See it? This would be another loop instead of the initial loop. Or also the other option is using the relative velocity of between B and C and calculate the velocity of point C like this. First calculate B and then use the relative velocity without any loop. This is the other alternative solution. Okay. Everything was clear? I erased everything. Do you want to take the picture of my notes?
Yes, is that okay?
Yeah, sure.
Thank you.
The question will start here. And
just this question.
The second one. Here. This one. And on the back of it? No. Here. This two.
Okay.